My name is Kayvon Modjarrad, and I grew up in New Jersey. We are at the Vaccine Research Center in the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Disease at the National Institutes of Health. And I'm responsible for directing the advanced preclinical development of vaccines against respiratory viruses like influenza, respiratory syncytial virus, and something called Middle Eastern Respiratory Syndrome, a new coronavirus that's caused a number of deaths in the Middle East. I'm also sort of an intermediate to advanced juggler. I've always done that for a long time. So actually, I would say that I'm the first scientist in my family. My family immigrated from Iran a few years before I was born. And there were a number of people in my family that were in medicine and healthcare, and so there was some of that legacy that led me down this path. So I have a background in public health and epidemiology, and that's where I discovered it. It was at a lecture that one of our professors was giving, and he was talking about multi-drug resistant tuberculosis. I went and talked to him after that and realized that the kind of work that he was doing was exactly the kind of work that I wanted to be doing. I will take, for example, cells from patients, from people who have been infected with the particular virus, so RSV or respiratory syncytial virus, and I will sort out their cells that make those antibodies, and I will try and isolate out some of those antibodies that bind to particular parts of the virus. And we use those antibodies to help us design better vaccines. We use those antibodies potentially for treatment or passive immunity as well.
He was excited, yeah. So he suggested also looking at some of the G monoclonal antibodies.
Science is a very collaborative process. So some people have the idea that it's a solitary endeavor, and it's not at all. We have about 12 to 15 people in the lab. We have about 300 people in the Vaccine Research Center across the different labs. I think in the long term, we will have something that's close to a universal flu vaccine, something that is much more effective and much more long-lasting in the immunity that it provides. And then a respiratory syncytial virus vaccine, I think, because of the discoveries that have been made here at the VRC and in other laboratories, we will have a vaccine, I'm fairly confident, not only within my lifetime, but before I retire, next couple of decades, I think so. I didn't really know what I wanted to do until I got to medical school and I saw all the different options in research and in biomedical research that were available to me, and get out there and talk to people on your campus and within scientific organizations. There are a lot of opportunities for young people interested in science.